Well, dear friends, this is our English period, and we are going to learn a very good story in this lesson. We are very social, and while living in society, we see many types of people, many types of kids, many types of children. Some are very bright, some are very emotional, some are very slow learner also. Some are very naughty, some are very hyperactive. They do every time something different. Some are technically good, some are singing well, some are dancing well. So, you know that we see that all colors in our society. If we see today's era, we develop each and every child according to their capabilities. But if we see our past era, few decades ago or centuries ago, that time there was discrimination in gender, complexion. Suppose somebody is not good looking, then there was discrimination on that. And that particular child was not getting that kind of justification or justice while living her or his life. And that was, you know, that was a very, you know, great clot of the society, we can say. It was a very bad thing in the society. Nowadays, we have washed out each and everything. We try to give all sort of justice to each and every individual. And that is why nowadays every individual is safe. Every father, every mother, all guardians try to take care of their own ward, own daughter, own son in their own way. They never keep anything behind while nurturing, while developing their kid. So, but as I said earlier, that in the past era, there was great discrimination. The boy, the girl, the son, the daughter, who is looking so fine, was beloved of anyone, everyone. And one who was looking so ugly or was not so good, not talented, was neglected and was given a very, you know, ill kind of treatment. So similar kind of situation we are going to learn in this story. It was in the past. The story's name is Bholi, which is written by K. A. Abbas. If we think about the K. A. Abbas, he's an all-rounder personality in field of literature, because he has done many things. First, we'll see his full name, K. A. Abbas, Khwaja Ahmed Abbas. His full name was. He was film director. He was screenwriter. He was novelist. He was journalist, and he had written his literature in Hindi, Urdu, and English language. So by this, we can understand his superiority. That he was the person, or he is the person who had all sort of knowledge. He was master in all. He was director. He was screenwriter. He was novelist. He was journalist. So what was not there in his personality? And he has written a true account of one girl, that is Bholi. You see a very little introduction about the Bholi. Bholi was actually not, her name was not Bholi, but she was lacking behind in her beauty, in her intelligence. That is why her father, her parents used to call, or all over the people of the village also used to call her Bholi. Bholi was not her real name. It was given nickname because of her outer appearance and her condition. She was Bholi. Means what? Bholi means what? Innocence, we can say. Nothing she knows, that type of things. Okay. She was youngest girl of Ramlal. Ramlal is father of Bholi, and she is youngest, is very small. And once what happened, when she was very young, when she was a very small child, that time she has fallen down from the cot, from her bed, and little part of her head, brain was damaged. And that is why she started stammering. She couldn't speak fluently as we speak. Okay? And the atmosphere, the situation was also made like that. You are stammering. Nobody tried to make her fluent. Nobody tried to encourage her that you can speak. You know that when you were small, that time your father and mother had encouraged you that you can walk. Many times you fall down. You know that, ask your mother and father. Many times you fall down, but your father never said, your mother never said that you don't have any quality to walk. You don't have strength to walk. No, no. They have encouraged you. That is why you could walk. Now you could run and you win the athletic race as well. It why? Because your father encouraged you, or the father made you very optimistic about that. But in that era, the parents, their whole village, people of the whole village make her very pessimistic that you can't do anything. You are stammering. Stammering is what? The person who fumbled while using words or while speaking. Means there is big gap between two letters. No, means the person who couldn't speak fluently or couldn't speak like a normal person. That is called stammer. Okay? She was, her little part of the brain was damaged. And that is why she stammers while speaking. Again, one more unfortunate thing happened with her. That is, she got the disease of the chickenpox, and that is why pock marks were there on her whole body except eye. And that is why she was not looking so good, so beautiful like other three daughters. Actually, Ram Lal had three sons and four daughters. That time, there was not that awareness among the that there should not be big population of the family. That is why. And that is why, suppose one of the girl was not good or one of the boy is not good, then she or he would not have got that justice in the family. Okay, so she was stammering, she was having that pock marks on her face and whole body except eye, and that is why she was looking so ugly, and that is why she was neglected in her family as well as whole village. Everybody was making fun of her. Now, can you imagine how she was feeling that time? She was totally lost her confidence, and that is why she was totally feeling like a cow in her house. One incident is given in that lesson. And so, this particular character of Bholi, A.K. Abbas has depicted very supremely. While reading the lesson, while listening the lesson, we can understand, we can get the picture of Bholi in front of our eyes. That is the quality, that is the good work of K. Abbas. By his pain, by his words, we can understand the character of the Bholi, how Bholi was getting embarrassed in many situations that we are going to see. Okay, so we see directly the lesson. The name of the lesson is Bholi. So introduction is given here. From her very childhood, Bholi was neglected at home. Why did her teacher take special interest in her, and did Bholi measures up her teacher's expectation? And suppose you are fumbling somewhere, you become so negative, then somebody should be there. It may be your friend, it may be your mother, father, or it may be your younger brother, younger sister, or your teacher, or any neighbor who can make you positive, and you can become a very good personality. It depends on who you will get to show the direction. Somebody should be there who can guide you, somebody should be there who can make you positive. And that had happened in the life of Bholi, Miss Sulekha. We should not say Bholi, she is Sulekha, but because she was not looking so good, when she was born, that time she was very good looking child, very good looking. She was very fair in complexion, she was very beautiful. As she has engrossed with the disease like smallpox, and she has fallen down from the cot, and she has totally lost her whole life. Not exactly she was unable to walk, but she was being neglected through in the family. Just see, if the family members couldn't see her, then what about the other people? and that we are going to see in this lesson. Her name was Zuleika, but since her childhood, everyone had been calling her Bholi, the simpleton. Her name was Zuleika, but as she was not that impressive, that is why everyone used to call her Bholi. Means Bholi means ignorant, like that. She was the fourth child, daughter of the Numbardar Ramlal. He was Numbardar, he is a revenue official. When she was 10 months old, she had fallen off the cot on her head, and perhaps it had damaged some part of her brain. As I told you, she had, when she was 10 months old, that time, you know, that when you are very small, you don't know what exactly happening with you. And that is why she was very ignorant, nobody was might be there. And that is why she had fallen down from the cot, and that is why some part of the brain was got damaged. And that is why she started stammering, she couldn't speak, because she couldn't speak for 5 years, and after that she has started speaking, but her speaking was like a sort of mumbling. She was mumbling while speaking. That was why she remained a backward child and came to be known as Bholi, a simpleton. She couldn't speak, she couldn't answer, she couldn't react. And that is why everybody was thinking that she is not good now, she is abnormal. So everybody was calling her Bholi, simpleton. At birth, the child was very fair and pretty. She was very beautiful. She was very gorgeous when she was very small. But when she was 2 years old, she had an attack of smallpox. Only the eyes were saved, but the entire body was permanently disfigured by deep black pockmarks. Little Zuleika could not speak till she was 5, and when at last she learned to speak, she stammered. It was very, very unfortunate thing for her that she couldn't speak like other children do. And that is why she found herself very negative in front of every small kid, every family member. The other children often made fun of her and mimicked her. And you know that when somebody is not speaking properly, then we mimic. We speak like her or him, and then we make fun of her or him. And then she become or he becomes so unhappy, sad, nervous that we do. We should not do that, because this is, you know, we should not hurt anyone. But she was getting the similar kind of situation every day, every now and then as well. As a result, she talked very little, because everybody was insulting her, everybody was making fun of her, and that is why she talked less, so that the talking, the speech was not developed properly. You know that initially when we have, you know, we are living in a joint family, then we familiarize with the many words and we speak a lot. Nowadays, many people now around every family, nuclear family, they live with their father and mother. They don't live in a joint family. So the child who is born in the family speak less, because he or she doesn't have that much, treasure of the words. Because father, mother goes for the office, they remain with their maid or one of the person who takes caretaking, and then they speak very less. If we see earlier age, we can see that we were living in a joint family. Many person like father, mother, uncle, aunt, then grandfather, grandmother, many uncles. So everybody was speaking that in front of the child, and that is why child used to get many words in Marathi. Nowadays, even though we are from Marathi background, we don't know many Marathi words. As we go in English medium, we speak very fluent English. We have many words for understanding in English, but not in Marathi. Some words when we speak in Marathi, when we ask something that we need, what is the meaning in Marathi, then we can't express that. So that is what. So there should be proper background atmosphere of language. And that is why nobody was speaking with her. That is why she speaks less. And that is why the development of the language, development of the speech was not there in her character. Ramlal had 7 children, 3 sons and 4 daughters, and the youngest of them was Bholi. Bholi means Zuleika, again I say. It was a prosperous farmer's household, and there was plenty to eat and drink. And Ramlal was very, wealthy and prosperous farmer. That is why there was much, thing to eat. The son had been sent to the city to study in schools and later in colleges. And he was very cautious, he was very great, gentle father for three sons and three daughters, not for Bholi. Because Bholi was not good looking, Bholi was not normal child, she was abnormal because she was fallen down and she was not speaking like other his kids do. And that is why the unfortunate treatment was got in her side. The son had been sent to the city and study in the schools and later in colleges. Of the daughters, Radha, the eldest, had already been married. She was very good looking and she was eldest. Then the second daughter's Mangla's marriage had also been settled, and when that was done, Ramlal would think of the third Champa, because he had four daughters, Radha, then Mangla, and then Champa, and last one Sulekha. But he was not thinking about Sulekha, because Sulekha was, his Bholi was not in the right kind of mind. They were good looking, healthy girls, and it was not difficult to find bridegrooms for them. But Ramlal was worried about the Bholi. She had neither good looks nor intelligence. She was not so intelligent like others and was not good looking also, because she had pock marks on her face. And you know that beauty is the real strength of any girl, any lady. And she was not, the beauty was absent in her character, on her face, appearance. And that is why he thought that my daughter Bholi, Miss Sulekha, is not that good for the other things. Bholi was 7 years old when Mangla was married. The same year, primary school for girls was open in the village. The Tahsildar Sahib came to perform its opening ceremony. He said, "Ramlal, as a revenue official, you are the representative of the government in the village, and so you must set an example to the villagers. You must send your daughters to school." Now, Tahsildar Sahib had come when he had come to inaugurate a primary school in the village. That time, that some official government officers used to come. Nowadays, politicians comes for that. But before that, government officials who had a good highest rank, they used to come for the opening ceremony or inauguration of anything. That time he had come, and when he met Ramlal, and he said that now school has established, we have started school in the village, then you should set the example as you are government official, you are revenue official. So you have to start the example, you have to set the example for the whole villagers, and you have to send your daughters to the school. He said, "Okay, you must send your daughters to school." That night when Ramlal consulted his wife, "Are you crazy?" His wife said, "Are you crazy? If girls go to school, who will marry them?" Because that time there was orthodox thinking among the society. Girls could not go out, girls should not go out, must not go out. If they will go out, means they are not good girls, they are barren characters. Nowadays, you know that our girls are pilot, our girls are, highest rank in the parliament as well. You know that Pratibhadai Patil was the president of our India. She was former president of our India. Then we see and Indira Gandhi. Now many are there. Kiran Bedi, we can see many examples set by the women in India, in all over the world. But that time the scenario was very different. Scenario was very discouraging for the girls. But he said that you have to set the example. And that time when he asked the same thing to his wife, she said, "Are you crazy? How can you say that girls can't go out? They can't go out. Who will marry with them?" But Ramlal had not the courage to disobey the Tahsildar, because he was servant of the Tahsildar. He was highest in rank. At last, his wife said, "I will tell you what to do. Send Bholi to school, as it is there a little chance of her getting married." Just see how mother was. As I told you, in the family there was injustice, discrimination among the kids. So other girls were good looking. That is why they will get a problem of getting married. But now Sulekha, Miss Bholi, was not that good looking, and she was like abnormal child. So we will send her, so that you will save yourself also, and we will save our all three girls also. Now this girl is not that good, so okay, fine, we will let her go to school. So just see how was the thinking of that mother in that era. You see, it was good because of that decision. Bholi, Miss Sulekha had changed her life, changed her personality. At last, his wife said, "I will tell you that what to do. Send Bholi to school, as it is there is a little chance for of her getting married. With her ugly face and lack of sense, let the teachers at the school worry about her." Now, Shiv also was wanted to take greed of her. So let her teacher will take worry about her. The next day, Ramlal caught Bholi by the hand and said, "Come with me. I will take you to school." Bholi was frightened because it was very unprecedented for her that nobody was taking her to anywhere. And that is why she was very frightened. "Why, where my father is taking me out?" She did not know what a school was like because she was totally, you know, restricted in the four walls only. Because she was ugly, she was not good looking, she was stammering. So she was totally, restricted in the four walls. She remembered how a few days ago their old cow Lakshmi had been turned out of the house and sold. So she thought that maybe my father is selling me. So she was totally, reluctant to go out. "No, no, no," she said, shouted in the terror and pulled her hand away from her father's grip. She said, "No, I don't want to come because I don't sell out myself. I am not cow. Don't do like this. Please show mercy on me." What is the matter with you? You fool? Is this the way the father should ask her daughter? You fool? You stupid? This is the names? This is the calling names for her daughter? For his daughter, shouted Ramlal, "I am only taking you to school." Then he told his wife, "Let her wear some decent clothes today, or else what will the teachers and other school girls think of us when they see her?" They see the sentence, what they will think of us, not about her. They don't have anybody about her image, about her prestige, about their own prestige. They are making her good looking. Means by the appearance, for them, not for Sulekha, not for Bholi. New clothes had never been made for Bholi because she was getting all sort of injustice. The old dresses of her sisters were passed on to her. No one cared to mend or wash her clothes. But today she was lucky to receive a clean dress which had shrunk after many washing and no longer fitted Champa. Now Champa couldn't wear because it was so shrunk. That is why it was given to Sulekha when they have to take her to the school, and people should not say anything, teachers should not say anything about the family. That is why they are giving the dress to Sulekha. She was even bathed in oil. Just see the sentence. She was even bathed. Means it was clearly sensed that she was not getting the proper regular bath and was not getting any oil temp to her hair. Was rubbed into her dry, actually be power oil. Rubbed means what? It was very new for her to take oil on her hair. It was sometimes maybe in the middle, or suppose some oil fit on the ground, maybe it might have taken to her. So her hair were very dry. Oh, so he rubbed into her dry and matted hair. Only then did she begin to believe that she was being taken to a place better than her home. Nobody made her understand that we are taking you somewhere else. Just see now, suppose any kid is not doing well, your parents take you to tuition classes so that your son, your daughter should do something better. But here, now Tahsildar said something and I will not disobey him. That is why parents have taken decision that Bholi, who is not, there is no chance that she will get married with anyone. That is why they are taking for the sake of the people, not for them, not to develop herself. When they reached the school, the children were already in their classroom. Ramlal handed over his daughter to the headmistress. Left alone, the poor girl looked about her with fear-laden eyes. There were several rooms, and in each room, girls like her squatted on mats. What did we saw? They were sitting on the knees. Okay, that time it was very old era. and they were not benches. They were sitting on the mats and squatted knees on the knee. Reading from the books or writing on slates, the headmistress asked Bhuli to sit down in the corner in the classroom. Bhuli did not know what exactly school was like and what happened here or there. But she was glad to find so many girls almost of her own age present there. And she has found that many girls were there who were almost of her own age. She hoped that one of these girls might become her friend, because friend, this particular concept was not in her life. She was totally unaware about the friend, and it is why that she could say, she was thinking that one of the girl will become my friend so that I can speak with her, I can share something with her, because nobody is there in her house who can ask her, oh, how are you, what do you want, anything like that. The lady teacher who was in the class was saying something to the girls, but Bhuli could not understand, but Bhuli could understand nothing because she was unfamiliar with all these things. She looked at the pictures on the wall, the colors fascinated her. Now, first time she was there in the school, something different place, unusual place, and that is what she's trying to see everything with the great fascination. She has seen something like the horse was born just like a brown, just like a horse on which the tahsildar had come to visit their village. The goat was black like a goat of their neighbor. Then parrot was green like the parrot she had seen in the mango orchard, where mango trees are there. And the cow was just like their Lakshmi. And suddenly Bhuli noticed that the teacher was standing by her, smiling at her, and she was just looking here and there. She was totally engrossed in her own thoughts. Whatever she has seen in her background surrounding, that she was matching with the pictures of the classroom, which was stuck in the classroom. And that time, by the time, teacher was standing behind her and smiling at her. "What's your name, little one?" She said, "Bho, bho, bho." She couldn't stammer, she could stammer no further than that. Then she began to cry, and tears flowed from her eyes in a helpless flood. And she was trying to speak, "My name is Bhuli," but she couldn't. And that is why she was unable to speak her name, utter her name. That is why she became so absolutely nervous, and she started crying. She kept her head down as she sat in the corner, not daring to look up at the girls who she knew were still laughing at her. And when she was just telling her name, that time she stammered. She couldn't say her name properly. That is why all the girls were laughing. That is why she became so nervous, she became so frightened, and she couldn't see that good girls also. The school bell rang. All the girls scurried out of the classroom, but Bhuli dare not leave her classroom corner. Her head still lowered, she kept on sobbing. She was crying because now she thought that in the home also she was insulted, and here also she was insulted. The teacher's voice was so soft. "Then again, what happened?" "Bhuli." Somebody uttered her name, "Bhuli." The teacher's voice was so soft and soothing. In all her life, she had never been called like that. Maybe everybody was screaming like that, "Bhuli, Bhuli," like that, but nobody has called her in a very gentle way. This was the first time she has listened that somebody is calling me with a great gentleness. "Get up," said the teacher. It was not a command, but just a friendly suggestion. Bhuli got up. "Now tell me your name." Sweat broke out over her whole body. Would a stammering tongue again disgrace her for the sake of this kind woman? However, she decided to make an effort. She had such a soothing voice, she would not laugh at her. And she thought that, okay, let me take some efforts so that I can say my name properly. "Bah, bah, bo, bo," she began to stammer. Well done," the teacher encouraged her. "Come on now, the full name." Then she again pronounced, "Bah, bah, bah, Bhuli." At last, she was able to say it and felt relieved, as if it was a great achievement, because first time she has uttered her full name. And somebody was listening. That is very, very great plus aspect of her life. That somebody listen her. And when she said completely bholi, she become like, she got that something, a good, great, grand achievement. Well done. The teacher patted her affectionately. Pat means she soothed her affectionately and said, put the fear out of your heart. You will be able to speak like everyone else. Just keep out your fear from your heart so that you can speak like others, because everyone can speak and you are also able to speak. Bholi looked up as if she was real. I can speak. She didn't say that, but by her expression, teacher can make out that. Yes, yes, yes. It will be very easy. You just come to school every day. Will you come? Bholi nodded. No, say it aloud. Yeah, yeah, yes. And Bholi herself was astonished that she had been able to say it. Didn't I tell you? Now take this book. The book was full of nice pictures, and the pictures were in colors. Dog, cat, goat, horse, parrot, tiger, and cow, just like Lakshmi. And with every picture was a word in a big black letters. In the month, you will be able to read this book. Then I will give you a bigger book, then a still bigger one. In time, you will be more learned than anyone else in the village. Then no one will ever be able to laugh at you. People will listen to you with respect, and you will be able to speak without the slightest stammer. So all this conversation was there between Bholi, Sulekha, and her teacher. Understand? Now go home and come back early tomorrow morning. And she said that now, okay, what exactly strategy of mine? That did you understand that? Okay, so now you go home and tomorrow morning you have to come again. Bholi felt as if suddenly all the bells in the village temple were ringing, and the trees in front of schoolhouse had blossomed into big red flowers. It means that she was feeling lucky, and she was feeling so happy also that something good happened. That is why writer has given that all the bells of the temples were ringing, and surrounding of her all red flowers had blossomed. Her heart was throbbing with a new hope and a new life. Now she got some one ray of hope that I can lead my good life. So till we'll stop. So what exactly we have seen? The Bholi, her family background, how she was. She was a fourth daughter. Actually, Ramlal had seven kids, three sons and four daughters. And Bholi was among the daughters, she was youngest one. Actually, when she was very small, when she was 10 months old, she has fallen down from the cot, and that is why some part of the brain was damaged. That is why she couldn't talk for the 5 years, and when she started talking, that time she was stammering. She couldn't speak fluent like other kids. She was fumbling while speaking. Again, one unfortunate thing happened in her life, that is when she was 2 years old, that time she had smallpox, and that is why pock marks were there on her face. That is why she was looking so ugly, and that is why everybody was making fun of her. Nobody was taking her in their own way. So once what happened, Tahsildar has come to inaugurate school, primary school in the village, and that time he had taken the promise from Ramlal that you will send your daughters to school because you have to set an example for the others, all villagers. And then he said same thing to her, to his wife. Wife said, no, we can't do that. When my daughters will go in the school to learn something, who will marry with them? And then she had an idea that, okay, we will send Bholi to school. Why? Because Bholi will not get married because she was ugly. And then next day when she was got up, something unusual happened there. Father was about to take her to outside. And that time she thought that it is similar like once before few days my own cow Lakshmi was taken away and sold. So she thought that maybe my father is behaving like the similar way. He might sell me. And then he said that, okay, I am going to take you to school. That time, then again they have, got the question of the prestige, that what people will say about me and you. Ramlal said. So they have taken Champa's dress, which was shrunk for her. They have taken to Sulekha, Miss Bholi. And that time, first hour, it was rarely happening in her life that she had bath and she has got good clean clothes and then oil on her hair. Then she was going to school, she went to school. That time she saw that many similar kind of age girls were there in the classroom. Headmistress said that sit in the corner. She was sitting and she was just trying to look here and there. She was trying to match the pictures with the animals in her surroundings. That time teacher was standing behind her smiling. What's your name, little one? She asked. And that time she was about to say, but she stammered. She couldn't say her whole name, Holi. She said, bo, 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 and then she stopped. And that time everyone saw that and they start laughing. And she couldn't digest that. She was crying like anything. She was crying very badly. And when that recess bell rang, that time all girls went out. And she remained still, lowered her head in the knee. And that time, again, teacher was there and teacher was asking, Bholi, that was very gentle call. That was unprecedented for the Bholi, that no one has had ever asked her, like a call her like that. And then she thought something positive in that teacher. And then she started again she stopped, again she said, and then she completely successful to say Bholi. And then she thought like, I have done something, I have got a big achievement. And that is why again she said, okay, you have to come regularly, then you will speak like others. And then she handed over one book which had some pictures in it and having a good caption in a big letter. And she said that this you will see, this for this month you have to read this book, and after I will give little bigger and more bigger, and within a month or two you will become absolute good learner, good speaker, and nobody will laugh at you and you will get proper respect. And then she had got, okay, I will learn, and she has got one positive outlook towards her life. So till this part of the lesson we have learned this much. You write the summary of the lesson and try to revise, because this is a very important chapter. If we see the history of the CBSE board, you will see that many of the questions have come from this lesson. So by the exam point of view, you have to give more weightage to this lesson. So I hope that you have understood this part of the lesson. Thank you very much.